Rouge the Bat is one of the more beloved female characters in the Sonic canon. Appearing in the very early 2000s, the character quickly grew a following, and has made numerous appearances in the Sonic games, television shows, and comics alike. But how much do you really know about Rouge the Bat? Well, today we're counting down our favorite facts about her with our top 10 Rouge the Bat surprising facts list. Some of these facts may be no surprise for seasoned Sonic fans, and for others, it may just put the character in a better light. So let's get to it. Number 10, Nails the Bat. Originally, Rouge was supposed to be named Nails the Bat. Her name was changed before her first appearance in 2001's Sonic Adventure 2 to better suit her personality. Since then, the character has appeared in 28 games in the franchise, with some of those appearances being playable and others simply just her making an appearance, like in Sonic Jump Fever. The character has also been used as a trophy, like in Super Smash Bros. For the Nintendo 3DS. Outside of the games, Rouge's first appearance in the Archie comics was in Sonic the Hedgehog number 98, which was a cross-promotion issue with the release of Sonic Adventure 2. And at number 9, Yuji Uekawa. Speaking of her creation, the individual responsible for Rouge is Yuji Uekawa. Yuji is one of the character designers at Sega, and a member of Sonic Team. He started his career at Sega working on Sonic R, and was responsible for the series' redesign that occurred in 1998 with Sonic Adventure. Aside from Rouge, he's also responsible for creating another Sonic fan favorite, Knuckles the Echidna. Up next, number 8, her espionage career. Rouge is more than just a pretty face. The character is a jewel thief and a government spy working for the President of the United Federation. If those credits weren't enough, she also works as an agent on loan for the Guardian Units of Nations, also known as GUN, who are a worldwide military and law enforcement organization. In addition to her stacked resume, she's also a world-famous freelance treasure hunter, and definitely loves her some jewels, including the likes of the Master Emerald and Chaos Emeralds. Her career in espionage has given her a ton of training and experience when it comes to combat, stealth, and infiltration. Up next, number 7, Sonic Forces Mod. One of the many complaints fans have had with the most recent Sega-developed Sonic game, Sonic Forces, was that you weren't able to play any of the beloved cast of supporting characters. This also includes Rouge, but luckily someone has made a mod for the game in which you can play as the character, and it's also available for some other awesome characters too. And at number 6, voice actors. There are two voice actors who have lent their talents to Sega for Rouge. Rumi Okai of Japan has voiced Rouge in 15 titles, and Kathleen Delaney has voiced her in 8, including the likes of Sonic 06, Sonic Rivals, and Sonic Rivals 2. Rumi, on the other hand, is known for her work in the Naruto franchise, while Kathleen has voiced multiple characters in the Yu-Gi-Oh! Franchise, including My Valentine. And at number 5, her furry fandom. It should be no surprise to you that the Sonic franchise has a pretty extensive furry fandom. If you don't know what a furry is, maybe go give that a Google right now. Make sure your safe search is on. Trust me. Got it? Okay, good. All things physically considered, it makes sense why Rouge has a big following in that fandom, with her often being portrayed as a fleeting seductress who uses her raw sexual appeal with great liberty. The community has also a few running jokes about Rouge, joking that her breasts are filled with gas, which is why she's able to fly with such large ones that they themselves often inflate in fan art, and that her adoration of jewelry is actually a sexual euphemism. And at number 4, her relationship with Knuckles. Knuckles and Rouge are usually depicted as rivals. The two have been fighting over the Master Emerald since Rouge's introduction into the Sonic universe, but often their relationship has been depicted as a romantic one. Sort of. It's like, kinda subtle. By the end of Sonic Rivals 2, when they team up, she's calling him dashing and daring. Rouge's flirtations also carry over into her interactions with Knuckles in the comics, making his comic beau, Julie Sue, pretty jealous from time to time. Up next, number 3, her name. We mentioned earlier that Rouge initially was intended to be Nails the Bat, but her name was changed. So why did Rouge stick? Well, there's a lot of debate over that. First off, some believe that it comes from her being introduced as a love interest for Knuckles, who is red, hence calling her Rouge, which is the French word for red, if you didn't know. Another popular theory is that the word Rouge has some historical connotations to certain kinds of behavior, most of which Rouge herself exhibits, that behavior being less than wholesome, i.e. flirting, dancing, drinking, although she doesn't really do the latter. Other fans have connected her name to the city of Baton Rouge in Louisiana, which is home to a large population of bats. Get it? She's a bat. Up next, number 2, her parents. Rouge is one of the only characters to ever talk about her parents in the franchise. In the game, she mentions her mother, who she refers to as Mama in the Nintendo DS game Sonic Chronicles The Dark Brotherhood. Aside from familial relationships, those platonically closest to Rouge are Shadow the Hedgehog and NE123 Omega, with Shadow being her best friend and Omega making for a close second. And finally, in our number 1 spot, Dominatrix outfit. For years, Rouge has been criticized as being too much of an overtly sexualized character in Sonic games. She's even gotten heat from parents of kids who play the games for having inappropriate mannerisms. Whether or not you agree, it turns out you can actually make the character even sexier if you wanted to in Sonic Adventure 2. The game features multiple unlockable outfits for various characters, and one of Rouge's includes a Dominatrix-inspired outfit. It's unlocked after clearing all of Rouge's missions in the game. There's also a Christmas one and a Halloween-themed outfit, and even a risque two-piece one available too. Alright, there we have it, friends. How do you feel about Rouge the Bat? Great Sonic character or a useless supporting nobody? Let us know in those comments below. If you dug this video, please show some love by hitting those like, subscribe buttons. Don't forget to check out the playlist that's currently up on your screen right now for more gaming videos. And lots of Sonic ones too. In the meantime, thanks for watching, everybody. Catch you all in the next one.